Japanese artifact dealer Nick Ricupero, who has traveled from Canada to sell a remarkable item from 14th century Japan.
Hi, Nick.
Hello.
Tell me what you've brought in.
Today, I brought a 14th century samurai sword.
There's a mystical aura that surrounds the samurais. Why is that?
Samurai lived by his blade, ultimately. This is what would either preserve his life or take his enemies.
Wow, that is terrifying.
Yeah. This is one for you, boys.
That's the best samurai sword I have ever seen. Look at that blade.
Oh, the blade is just terrifying.
The samurai warriors were the officer caste of medieval and early modern Japan. They lived by a strict code of conduct called Bushido, based on honor, discipline, and morality, which has become the basis for much of Japanese society today.
So was this sword connected to anyone who was influential?
This belonged to a very famous daimyo family called the Date clan.
I mean, how old are we, Andrew?
They are hard to date. If this is an early one, I tell you what we were making in this country was just pathetic in comparison.
That's going to be worth money. A lot then, isn't it?
In 2001, a 13th century sword from the Date family of Daimyo sold for nearly £147,000. The Japanese government classified that sword as an important art object. While allowing foreign ownership, it could not leave the country.
How much do you want to sell it for today?
I want to sell it for £25,000.
So what would you do with the money if you sold?
I would probably put that money towards further enlarging my collection.
Well, I've seen a few samurai swords in my time, but I've never seen any really good ones. That today was just an enormous pleasure.
Dealers, this is Nick.
Hello, Nick.
Hello, dealers.
Andrew, is this a weapon of choice?
Oh, I think it pulses with menace. Please tell us how old it is.
The blade dates back to the late 1300s.
Whoa, my... I mean, suddenly the wonder is just doubled.
Tell us about it then, come on, we're all dying to know.
This belonged to what we call a daimyo. It was a feudal lord of ancient Japan. So this has been in their private collection for several hundred years.
You bought this from the family?
I bought this from a private collector. The family relinquished the blade after World War II, and it has been in private collection since.
Does that mean the blade itself has an actual history where we know what it did?
The gold inlay that you see on the handle is actually a record of an event that took place in 1661 AD. The Japanese had a very unique way of testing the sharpness of their items. So this blade successfully cut through the mid area of two bodies stacked one on top of the other.
Were they alive?
Most likely dead.
Well, dealers, a lot to think about. Back to your rooms.
Thank you.
It's frightening, it's creepy, it's a thing of beauty, but it's a weapon. I'm flummoxed by it and slightly in awe of it.
This sword is unbelievably beautiful, but I think Nick's going to want a lot of money for it, and it worries me.
I don't think the dealers have ever quite reacted like that to an object before. So who do you think's most interested to buy it?
Andrew or Alex seem to be interested, but Celia was quiet but intrigued nonetheless.
Well, what's your room order?
I'll start with Pearl, then I'll make my way to Alex, Celia, and then Andrew.
Pearl's waiting, so off you go.
Right, thank you.
The dealers were all fascinated by the sword. Nick has decided to start with the dealer he feels is least likely to buy it. Pearl in room one.
Hi, Nick.
Hi, bro.
Come sit down, nice to meet
you. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Thanks so much for bringing the sword in. I'm not going to waste your time with it. I'm obviously not going to be in the running for one of these. I'm going to offer £100. I know that's not what it's worth, but it's not my kind of thing.
I'll kindly decline it. It was a real pleasure. Thank you very much, Bob. Take care.
Nick correctly guessed that Pearl would be standing on the sidelines in the battle for the sword. Time to move into more promising territory with Alex in room two.
Hello, Nick.
Hi, Alex.
Nick, you look ridiculously young. How come you're so young and dealing in such beautiful, fine things? Were you always destined for this?
That might just be the reason.
And is there any Japanese family link?
None whatsoever. I'm actually of Italian descent.
Okay, Nick. I know a little bit about Japanese art, but even then, samurai swords are a very separate part or genre of Japanese art. So I'm assuming that this is considerably in excess of £10,000.
That is absolutely correct.
I couldn't buy it for myself because it's just with three children. It's just too terrifying a thing to have around. It's not my thing, so my offer would be 7.5, and I'm sad that you'll probably say no to that.
I will have to decline it, unfortunately.
It was an absolute pleasure. Take care.
Thank you, Alex. Take care.
Okay, bye-bye.
Having closed the door on Alex's £7,500 bid, Nick moves on to see if Celia is a serious contender.
Hello, Nick.
Hello, Celia.
Nice to meet you.
Pleasure
again,
to meet you as well.
Properly. It's absolutely stunning, and it's something I would need someone very special as a client to buy. I don't have that person in mind, so if I can get it for a really good deal, then I'm prepared to wait and find a buyer.
What would be a good deal for yourself?
£5,000.
The certification alone costs about £1,000.
Well, I'm not going to go any higher. And the reason is because I don't know enough about it. So I stick to £5,000. But thank you very much.
I guess I'm off to the next room. Thank you very much.
Nice to meet you.
Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Nick's last chance to sell at his target price of £25,000 lies with Andrew in room four.
Hello, Nick.
Hello, Andrew.
Have a seat.
Pleasure to meet you.
Yeah, you too. There's something very menacing about it, but also really beautiful, I think. I don't know about samurai swords a lot, so I'm flying blind here. Is a blade made in the 1700s going to be a better blade than this one made in the 1300s?
Not necessarily. Collectors typically collect all eras, but there's something about the old era where the blade was being built for actual battle that really draws in collectors these days.
How much do you want for it?
How much are you willing to offer?
Well, I told you I'm flying blind, so you're going to have to hold my hand here.
I was looking to get $27,000 for it.
Dollars?
Pounds.
No. It depends whether you've come here to actually sell it and go home with some money or not. I'm going to offer you $9,000. How about that?
That's nowhere near. I'll be willing to come down on the price.
Yeah, you need to. Go on, come down. Come on, come down. Do it now. And start getting below 20 quickly.
$22,000.
No. $10,000.
Andrew, reach through all your contacts, you will not be able to get your hands on a daimyo piece.
$11,000.
Absolutely not. I have to decline.
What if I told you that's my last offer?
Then I'll take that nice long walk out the door.
I'm going on instinct only. Come down.
$19,500. That's.
No, I don't like the 500 bit. So I'm going to call that 19,000.
This is rare, rare piece of Japanese history.
It better be.
With the highest provenance that's probably available.
14,000.
Can't do it. I can't. My last and final offer was 18,500.
No, it's not. No, it's not. Because I mean,
it's my last and final
offer. Because wouldn't it be silly for us to both be sitting here? I come up to 15,000, and you go, "Oh my God!" For the sake of £3,000, you drop the ball.
I'd be donating it to you.
Would you?
At that price,
you wouldn't be donating it to me.
It's really at that that point where it starts to get tight around the neck. So
just give me a moment to think. 18,500 pounds.
you have yourself a deal.
Great.
Thank you.
Thank you, Andrew. It was a pleasure working with you.
My pleasure, too. Yeah, good. We'll be talking.
Yeah, we'll be in touch.
Okay. Thank you. £18,500. Is it a lot of money for something that fabulous? Probably not. Well, I'm going to find out.
Congratulations, that was some battle, Nick.
It was indeed.
Are you pleased with the price?
I definitely recognize that Andrew is a dealer. He definitely got the upper hand on this one. Hopefully he'll come back to me and we'll be able to deal again in the future.
Well, congratulations and well done.
Thank you, Sarah.
By holding his nerve in a hard-fought battle with Andrew, Nick has sold his sword for £18,500. Andrew has sold the samurai sword to a museum in America.